Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here. Welcome to the channel. We're here in the Fenix A320 inside Microsoft Flight Simulator. And today we're going to have a look at the Airbus autobrake system. So what does the autobrake system do for us? The system has two main purposes. The first is to reduce the braking distance in case of an aborted takeoff. And the second is to establish and maintain selected deceleration rate during landing, thereby improving passenger comfort and reducing crew workload. They're sort of the two main reasons we use the autobrake system. See here, we've got the autobrake panel. Got a low setting and a medium setting. These are used for landing. And we have a max setting, which is armed prior to takeoff and is only used for takeoff. In order for the autobrake system to be operating, we have to have the normal braking system functional, i.e. the green hydraulic system. And it's important to remember that the autobrake system is linked to activation of the ground spoilers. So if the spoilers do not deploy, autobrakes will not kick in. On a rejected takeoff, we do not get spoiler activation below 72 knots, and therefore we will not have application of the autobrake max setting. The autobrake max setting will provide maximum braking as soon as ground spoilers are extended. In terms of the other deceleration rates, which we have linked to our modes we use on landing, low and medium, low autobrakes will apply brake pressure 4 seconds after ground spoiler extension, and will decelerate the aircraft at a rate of 2 meters per second. And the medium setting will apply braking 2 seconds after ground spoiler activation, will decelerate the aircraft at 3 meters per second. So it's just important to understand the differences. One kicks in slightly later than the other, and they've both got a slightly heavier deceleration rate. Medium's got more than obviously low. And you'll see the decel lights, a little green light will come on here, and that indicates that brakes are achieving an 80% deceleration rate. System can be deactivated, obviously, by pressing one of these buttons again, and we would always confirm activation of the particular autobrake setting on the lower ECAM wheel page. You can see down here, don't rely on this light alone, so it's important to remember that. And also, in this case for takeoff, we also have the reminder on the upper ECAM takeoff config page. So in the terms of deceleration rates, that's really useful for us, because when doing landing calculations, we have to input a brake setting, because the aircraft needs to know how quickly we're going to be slowing the aircraft down. Obviously, if we pilot braking, manual braking varies between pilots. Some will apply it heavier than others. So we need to put into the computer a known rate of deceleration in order to calculate our landing performance and how much runway distance we need on landing. So that's really helpful from that point of view. Also, you know, as pilots, we want to achieve perhaps a particular vacate point on the runway. So, you know, we bring up the chart for London Luton. You know, we may want to think, okay, can we make exit Charlie here with the current weights and auto brake medium, for example? And a quick rule of thumb for that would be, we can use the scale down here at the bottom. We can sort of measure that distance from the start of the runway, the touchdown zone, approximately 800 meters there. Let's do a quick calculation. So we've got a gross weight of 60 tons today. For a medium autobrake calculation, we take our gross weight, we times it by 2, which gives 120, add a 0, 1200 meters required. So we're not going to make vacate point Charlie on the runway today. And again, the same calculation for the low autobrake setting, we take the gross weight and we times that by 3, 180, add a 0, 1800 meters is required on autobrake low as an approximate rule of thumb. So that's useful one to keep in your mind when doing your landing performance calculations, especially if you have to do a quick change of runway, for example. It's important to remember that the autobrake system will need to apply different pressures in order to achieve a particular deceleration rate. So on a wet day, when the runway surface is obviously not as efficient for braking, the system will have to work harder, apply more braking, and as a result of that, we can get higher brake temperatures. And that's something we need to factor in as well when making our autobrake selection decision. If we have a fast turnaround, and you know, we could opt to brake harder and vacate faster, but would, as a consequence of that, we would have higher wheel temperatures, which are shown down here on the wheel page. We need those temperatures to be below 300 degrees for a departure again, so we want to make sure we're not cooking the brakes for on a fast turnaround. But obviously, in terms of wear and tear of the aircraft, braking system, autobrake lows, you know, a preference to use where we can. So in terms of maintaining the life of the brakes, that's another factor to consider when, you know, choosing your deceleration rate there, low or medium. So in terms of arming the autobrake system, we can arm it by pressing on the ground. We can't know a medium not available. It's only max available for takeoff. The green hydraulic system has to be available. The anti-skid system has to have electrical power. There can't be a failure in the brake and steering control units, known as the BSCU. And we have to have at least one IRS functioning. We can apply autobrake, you know, can be armed when the park brake is on. So we can arm it before departure and setting off on the gate. Once the necessary systems have come online, usually after engine start. I mentioned about the need for ground spoilers to deploy for the braking system to activate, so that's important to remember. And in terms of disarming, we can simply disarm it again by pressing the control, or one or more of our arming conditions is lost, that will also disarm the autobrake system. Or if the flight crew applies enough deflection to at least one brake pedal when the autobrake system is active in any mode, that will also take the autobrake system out. The fourth reason for a disarm would be a touch and go to take off. So we're coming to land, doing circuits. Once we lift off again, the autobrake system, when we apply thrust again, the autobrake system will disarm and would need to be reapplied, reset for a next arrival. So that's system disarming. So you can see it's really useful for us in terms of calculating where we're going to exit the runway, being able to establish our landing performance, and also from a braking wear and tear point of view, and also passenger comfort. Nice equal pressure applied across the braking system, which is great to use where we can. Again, the pilot can override it at any point with the pedals, but we know we're going to achieve a certain landing performance by having these set deceleration rates set before landing. There's no requirement to use the autobrake system for landing. Some pilots don't. They prefer to apply manually braking. I guess, remember, if you're on medium and the ground spoilers deploy 2 seconds after landing, you get quite a heavy deceleration that can drop the nose very quickly. So something to remember is a bit of back pressure. If you've got the medium autobrake setting applied, it will get the nose down quite hard. So in terms of a comfortable landing, one to remember as well. Catches a few people out sometimes, that one. It's all about efficient braking, being able to calculate your braking performance, but a very useful tool on the Airbus. Any questions around that, please drop them in chat. Please like and subscribe if you like that content. Plenty more on the way. Thanks for watching.